see that? There was a plane, you didn't see it, there was a plane delayed on the runway for several hours, and as a gesture of goodwill, the pilot bought pizzas for everybody on the plane. I think we can agree, that's a nice thing he's done, that's a good thing, right? I saw an interview with him afterwards in which he said the phrase, "I am not a hero." He's obviously, he's not a hero. He probably doesn't need saying, mate, Christ. I am not a penguin. What's going through people's minds. I saw some graffiti in Southend where I live, and it's just baffled me. It's in kind of three stages. The first person, who was presumably called Claire, had written on a wall, "Claire was here," right? Second person, presumably not Claire, had come along, crossed out "was here," and had written in "sucks dicks." That's fairly horrible, but the third bit is a bit like air refuse. Then a third person had come along, and at the end of all that, had written in "for free." For free. It's that last bit I don't understand. What does "for free" add to the insult? Are you saying that Claire is not a prostitute? Isn't that just a good thing? You're criticising her business skills. You are right, that is a poorly constructed business model. Alan Sugar would be livid. You sucked all the dicks, you didn't take any money, you're fired. I am sorry about the icon turn. Ticket inspector at a train station in my local village, right? Which is fine, I've got no problem with that at all. The only problem I did have was he stopped me at the entrance to the station with a ticket machine being inside the station, right? So I tried to explain to him, it's not that I wasn't going to buy a ticket, it's that I hadn't bought a ticket yet, because I couldn't, because the machine was inside the station. And he was quite rude about it, he just kept going, "Can I see your ticket, please?" Right, and ignoring me. Eventually he lets me through, he watches me walk maybe 10 yards in front of him to the electronic ticket machine. He watches me buy a ticket, right? And he comes up to me and goes, "Can I see your ticket, please?" The ticket, he just watched me buy, right? Really irritated me. If there'd been a hedge there, I'd be off, right? But I thought, you know what? I'm not going to be out-dickheaded by this guy. I can out-dickhead pretty much anybody. So I'm just going to cheerfully and willfully misunderstand everything he says. He goes, "Can I see your ticket, please?" I go, I'm sorry, mate, I don't play the clarinet. I think you're thinking of my clarinet." He looks really confused. I talk about the clarinet for fucking ages. Until he gets really angry with me. And he goes, "I saw you get a ticket from that machine. Unless you show me that ticket, I'm going to give you a fine." Right? So he's now going to give me a fine because he knows I've got a ticket. So he's being a bellend of Crimean War proportions. Anyway, it's at that point I remembered I was on my way to a gig and I had a picture of David Hasselhoff with me. So he goes, "Can I see a ticket, please?" And I showed him that. He was very confused. I explained that to what ticket machine had given me. He said, "What?" I said, "The machine must have broken." And he said, "What?" I insisted that he file a formal report saying that electronic ticket machine was broken and you have cartoon pictures of David Hasselhoff instead of real tickets, right? At which point he got fed up with me and he walked away. Now, I would say that is probably my greatest ever achievement. But I will say this.